they feel and look incredibly expensive. You can walk down the street with any one of these pieces and you will be turning heads. Hello my friends, you asked for it, so here we go. Today we'll be doing a deep dive on perhaps one of the most underrated luxury houses, Bulgari. I love doing these individual brand reviews. I have done some on Cartier, Moina, Delvaux, just to mention a few. And if any one of those sound interesting to you, make sure to compile a playlist and leave it down in the info box. But today we'll be chatting about an Italian luxury house, Bulgari, that is of course most well known for their fine jewelry creations. And while that's a topic that we'll of course have to touch on, spoiler, I'll be placing a lot more emphasis on their bags, because I find it to be a category that doesn't get nearly enough love and attention. So if you want to hear my thoughts on Bulgari as a whole, and also come to one of their boutiques with me to check out their entire handbag collection, then please be sure to give this video a thumbs up and keep on watching. If you are a luxury lover, I know that you'll be familiar with Bulgari to some extent. Even if you don't own any pieces from them in your personal collection, you will still recognize a lot of what they do from a mile away, because they have such a strong design aesthetic that they have become well known for. But I wanted to rewind for a little bit and quickly discuss the heritage and the roots of Bulgari, because that is something that the brand goes back to this day to draw inspiration from. Because Bulgari has a really expansive history and heritage. They are an Italian luxury house that was founded in Rome in 1884 by a Greek silversmith, Sotirios Bulgaris, who ended up changing his name later on to Bulgari to make it just a little bit more stylized. And Bulgaris came from a really long line of jewelers and silversmiths. Over the years, they have developed this aesthetic that I was talking about earlier that is perhaps an acquired taste. It's definitely not for everyone. There are certain people who love them and others who prefer other more sort of subtle jewelry houses, because a lot can be said about Bulgari's aesthetic, but the word subtle cannot be used. Bulgari is known and beloved for their vivid and bold use of colors, innovative shapes and motifs, as well as their really generous use of precious metals. Bulgari pieces are going to be in your face, they're going to be ornate, they're going to be bold. And that's what you kind of expect from the brand at this point. If you want something that's really fine, subtle, and under the radar, I'm just going to put it out there, Bulgari is not going to be the brand for you, because they don't know the word subtle and timid when it comes to anything that they do. So Bulgari is definitely for those that want to make a statement with their pieces. And if you want to get a little bang for your buck, if you want pieces that are ornate, that are head turners, Bulgari is a brand that will win you over in no time. But without further ado, let's move on to talking about some of their actual collections that are very much worth looking into. And I wanted to start with their most iconic piece. This collection to Bulgari is what the Love Collection is to Cartier. This is what I like to call their pension fund. Let's be honest, these are the pieces that they sell enough of to keep the lights on, which is the B01 collection. I'm actually wearing the ring from this collection for you to see today. And I have to be honest, Bulgari is not my personal aesthetic. Even though I appreciate everything that they do, I appreciate the craftsmanship, the heritage, and the fact that a lot of their collections are quite reasonably priced, which, remind me, we'll have to talk about. It's not a brand that I necessarily would turn to. This was a gift from my mother-in-law quite a few years ago, which I'm really grateful to have in my collection, mainly because now I'm able to share with you my first-hand experience, but it's not necessarily a piece that I would buy for myself. But I know that the B01 collection is the most popular collection by far by Bulgari that you'll see the most of out there. They have rings, earrings, pendants, and even bracelets in this collection. So if you love the way this looks, you can buy the entire package. I would personally argue that the most popular pieces, based on what I see out there, are their rings and their pendants, but they create everything that they possibly can to please those who are very much a fan of the Bulgari brand. But what a lot of people don't know about these creations is that they're actually very much inspired by the heritage of the brand. Even though they look quite futuristic and modern, they go back to way before Bulgari was actually founded, to the times of the Colosseum, which is one of the most iconic symbols of Rome, and that was the inspiration and the base of the B01 line, which definitely gives this collection quite an architectural, bold, and daring look and feel. And I think the reason why this collection has become so popular is, number one, because the pieces in this collection are quite bold. And if you know Bulgari, if you're into luxury fashion, you will recognize these pieces in no time. So you have that brand recognition right there. And then the other aspect that perhaps made these pieces as popular as they are is that really unconventional use of materials. So a lot of the pieces in this collection, at least the original ones, blended precious metals such as gold with ceramic, which not only gave these pieces a unique unconventional look, a pop of color, but also made these pieces a lot less expensive than if they were made of all precious metals. Now these days they do have pieces that are made of all solid gold, and they use different treatments to make the bracelets and the pieces look a little bit more interesting. But the original pieces, the core of this collection, is the blend of ceramic with precious metals. If you're looking for a piece that is going to get you a lot of bang for your buck, one that you can easily take from day to night, a piece that you can wear consistently every single day and it will go with pretty much everything, mainly because of the coloring and the way it's set up, it is quite a casual piece that I feel is really easy to style, then this is a great collection to look into. Not to mention that compared to other luxury houses, for how much of a statement these make, I don't think they are too insanely priced, because you can actually find pieces in this collection that start just at around $2,000. Moving on from these bold architectural modern lines into something a lot more glamorous, the other collection that I wanted to introduce you to from Bulgari is their Serpenti collection, which in my eyes is just as iconic, if not even more, as their B01 collection. And this is one that has been around since the 1940s, and this Serpenti or snake head has remained their mascot, for the lack of a better word, for the past, what, over 80 years. And you might be thinking that it's kind of a weird choice to go for a serpentine head or for a snake head as the face of the brand, because snakes are such a touchy subject. Some people love them, some people have genuine phobias and they cannot even think of snakes without getting anxious. Well, I think if you know the meaning behind these pieces, that will definitely help to change your mind. All I can tell you is that it has sold me on this collection. Now, is it all marketing fluff? Yes, it probably is, but if you are as superstitious as I am, you will love the sound of this, because the way Bulgari looks at this idea of the serpentine head is that they see it as a positive sign and symbol of change, of evolving into a better, wiser version of yourself, and the sign of rebirth, because obviously snakes constantly shed their skin and they turn into something bigger and better. So the idea is that the best time to add one of these pieces to your collection is when you are ready to begin a new journey in your life, sort of as a talisman to have with you at all times. And then I have also been told by Bulgari in the past that serpentes are also seen sort of as a sign of protection, as a guardian. So by acquiring one of these pieces, you get this added protection. The question is, am I superstitious enough to believe in all of this? Yes, I am. But even if you're not, at the end of the day, you're getting some beautifully ornate pieces that are quite glamorous. Now, these are not for the faint of heart. All of the pieces in this lineup will be quite over the top. These are for the people who want really blingy, over the top pieces. But let's move on to, in my opinion, the best of Bulgari, which is their handbags. And I actually went to Bulgari just the other day to check out their entire handbag collection, because I personally don't own any pieces from them. I have friends that do, and that is how I was first introduced to the idea of Bulgari handbags. Now, personally, they are not my cup of tea, but all I can tell you is that I have tremendous appreciation and respect for the designs, for the quality, and most importantly, the attention to details, which is something that I feel like is not often discussed, or at least not often enough when it comes to Bulgari bags, because they have some jaw-droppingly beautiful creations. Just like how Bulgari has an entire fine jewelry collection inspired by the snakehead, they have the same when it comes to bags, which is the so-called Serpente Forever line, which is a collection that has to be my favorite. It's a line that I feel is so beautifully crafted that it's very much worth looking into. And these are pieces that you will really easily recognize if you know the brand well, because they have this incredibly detailed snakehead closure on the front, which after having the chance to play around with it and try it in person, I can tell you that it feels super heavy and substantial and really expensive. And what's really interesting about this closure, other than the fact that they are so beautifully crafted, is the fact that a lot of them are actually made of precious stones. So some of the snakeheads are made of quartz or onyx, but even if the snakehead itself is not made of precious stones, the eye will always be. So if you see the eyes being black, that means that they are made of black onyx. And if they're shining green, they're made of malachite, which is exactly what you would expect from a brand that is known for using some of the most beautiful, vivid, precious metals. Now, having the chance to play around with these pieces and really test them in person, I can tell you that they feel and look incredibly expensive. You can walk down the street with any one of these pieces and you will be turning heads. And I doubt that most people will know where these bags are actually from, because they're not nearly as widely recognized as Chanel or Dior bags, which personally I actually love. But you will for sure get a ton of questions on where these pieces come from, because they not only look incredibly expensive, but they are beyond special. And even if I had to guess the price of these bags, I would probably guess them to be twice, if not even three times, what they actually are. But that is far from where my rave review stops, because all of these bags are crafted in Italy using some of the most precious, beautiful calfskin that I would compare in terms of quality and feel to perhaps Dior, but I would say that it kind of surpasses the quality of Dior. They are just incredibly well made. They feel heavy, they feel sturdy, they feel substantial, but not heavy in a way that they would be overwhelming for you to wear. They just feel really well put together. And as soon as you open up these bags, you will truly see how much thought and effort has been put into the creation of these, not only on the outside, but also on the inside. First of all, you get a tiny mirror with every single one of your bag purchases, and you get a ton of functional compartments, from zip compartments through actual card slots and card holders, depending on how large the bag is that you purchase, which just shows to me that this was not a money grab trying to capitalize on the brand name, but these are actually bags that were thoughtfully put together and crafted for us to enjoy. Now again, Bulgari bags are not necessarily my aesthetic, but if you're looking for a really classy, elegant, expensive looking bag that is timeless, these are amazing pieces to go for. And if you want to go all out, I can do one even better for you, because Bulgari also creates most of their bags in exotic skins that are not nearly as ridiculously priced as you would think them to be. So they have bags, just to stay on brand, made of snakeskin as well as stingray. If you want something truly special, I would personally recommend that you look at their stingray bags, because those are ones that I really don't see too much of out there, but they are absolutely incredible. And they really give that additional tactile feel and texture to some of their bags. So as you can probably tell from all my rambling, I am a huge fan of Bulgari bags. And even though they're not pieces that I would personally pick up, they're not really my taste, I think they are absolutely stunning. If you want a bag that is truly unique, feels and looks expensive, but is not necessarily as widely recognized as something like a Chanel Double Flap would be, this is an amazing brand for you to turn to. And just to give you kind of an idea of what prices you'll be faced with, they're smaller bags, so they're kind of wallet on chains, start at $1,600. Their crossbody bags, which is sort of their next level up, are at around $2,600. And then their top handle bags, you can find at around the $3,000 price range, given that they are not in exotic skin. Which personally, yes, it's a crazy amount of money to spend on a bag, but compared to other luxury houses, for the quality and for the wow factor, I think it is quite reasonable. And this brings us to the end of today's deep dive on Bulgari. I hope you enjoyed this video, my friends, and I would love to hear what you have to say about Bulgari in the comment section. Have you tried their pieces? Do you own any pieces from Bulgari? I would love to know what you think. And if there are any other brands that you'd like me to do a similar deep dive on, let me know in the comment section too. And if you enjoyed this video, please be sure to let me know by giving this video a thumbs up and subscribing. And as always, thank you so much for watching. I appreciate you being here, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye.